Another quick short lesson for learning new ECMAScript stuff is string padding. So if I have a variable called x and it has this string on it, now that x is declared as a string, I now have access to a new method that has been added to strings in the newer ECMAScripts called padStart. And basically the first parameter is, how long do I want this string to be? And let's say I want it to be 10 characters long. And what do I add to the beginning of this string to fill out that space? And I'm going to add zeros to the front of it. And if I go ahead and log this new padded variable, you'll see that it is 10 characters long and it filled all those spaces in the beginning with zeros. So kind of like an easier way to write a new numbering system, for instance, and making sure that it always has the same amount of numbers on all of your potential variables. Similarly, I could do pad end to that, and it will add it to the backside of it. So yeah, that's a fast lesson. Okay, I'll see you on the next one.